American Top 40 originates in Hollywood. My name's Casey Kasem, and the countdown goes on. There are four versions of this next song currently in release. It's Mary Magdalene's song from the rock opera Jesus Christ Superstar. Karen Wyman's single of it was in the Hot 100 for several weeks a few months ago. Yvonne Elliman, who sings the role of Mary Magdalene in the original cast album, has a single out that's now on the charts. And Betula Clark has just released her version of the song. But here is the first to reach the top 40. Helen Reddy, I Don't Know How to Love Him. There's the fourth of six new songs on American Top 40 this week. We still have two to go. Coming in at number 28, Helen Reddy, and I Don't Know How to Love Him. This is Casey Kasem counting them down. We have two big hours and 27 hits to go on American Top 40. Stay right there. This is Casey Kasem in Hollywood, and it's time now for the current hit by a zealous advocate of women's lib who this month winds up a long concert tour because next month she's having a baby. She's already the mother of one little girl and has been a pretty outspoken campaigner for equal rights for women ever since her first hit record about a year and a half ago, a song from the score of Jesus Christ Superstar. She's from Australia and is married to an American who is also in the entertainment business, in the personal management end. In fact, he's her manager, and he's managed things pretty nicely for his wife, the singer. This is her fourth chart hit in 18 months. At number 27 this week, from Australia, here's Helen Reddy, I Am Woman.
I am woman, hear me roar.
There's your biggest moving record this week in American Top 40, up nine notches from 36 to 27. Helen Reddy.
American Top 40.
Helen Reddy was born and raised in Australia. Her father was a writer, comedic actor, and producer, and her mom was an actress in a TV series in Australia. At number 12, here's her biggest hit to date, I Am Woman.
I am woman, hear me roar, in numbers too big to ignore. I can face anything, I am strong.
Up five notches on American Top 40 to number 12, Helen Reddy and I Am Woman.
American Top 40.
Now on American Top 40, the 17th best-selling song in the country. And Helen Reddy's story of the talent contest she won, but couldn't really collect on because she was a girl. In 1966, she entered a talent contest sponsored by an Australian television station. She won first prize, which included a trip to New York and an audition with an American record company. Just what an undiscovered young singer dreams about. Now, when she got to New York, somebody from the record company took her to lunch and said, have a nice visit, and call us before you go back. But there was no audition. They were upset, says Helen, because she was a girl. 6 months later, when things still weren't going too good for her, she met artist's manager, Jeff Wald. When things weren't going so great for him either. Well, they got married, came to California, worked hard, made the right moves, and reversed their fortunes. For the past couple of years, things have been going very well for the lady from Australia.
In the morning fun when no one will be drunk.
Seventh week on AT40, moving up three notches, Helen Reddy and Peaceful as the countdown rolls on.
Casey's Coast to Coast.
At number one in the countdown this week is the artist whose Grammy Award acceptance speech of last March is probably better remembered than anybody's. When she stepped up to receive her statuette for Best Pop Vocal Performance by a Female, she said, I want to thank my husband and manager, Jeff Wald, because he makes my success possible. And God, because she makes everything possible.
Billboard's number one. You have on.
After a couple of weeks at number three, that's the new number one song in the land. Helen Reddy with Delta Dawn.
Casey's Coast to Coast.
Now at number eight on AT40 is the current hit by the lady who has 11 heads. She's a superstar singer, and she earns a superstar salary. And late last fall, she took a big bag full of that money, about $500,000 worth, and plunked it down on a new house for herself and her family. Now, she didn't buy just any house. Oh, no, she picked herself a place fit for a star. It sits on 3 acres of land in the middle of Brentwood, right next door to Beverly Hills. And it's divided into three separate buildings, with 6 bedrooms in the main house alone. Naturally, it includes all of your standard superstar features, like a swimming pool, a tennis court, and a huge garden. But as far as the total number of rooms on the estate are concerned, the lady of the house, Ms. Helen Reddy, says it's so big, even she doesn't know how many rooms she's got. But she tells us she's sure of one thing. Contained within those 3 buildings are 11 bathrooms, which should keep Ms. Reddy and her family ahead of any emergency that may come up. At number 8 this week, her latest single comes up a hit, and it's Ain't No Way to Treat a Lady.
I guess it was yourself you were involved with. That ain't no way.
She's still heading in an upward direction. Her name is Helen Reddy, and it's song number 8 this week on AT40, Ain't No Way to Treat a Lady.
Casey's Coast to Coast.
Time now for the current hit by a female vocalist who had such a tough time getting started that her friends threw a surprise fundraising party for her. It was back in the fall of 1968. The singer had just come to this country from Australia. She couldn't get a work permit right away, and the only jobs that she could get were singing at a wedding in Long Island, singing at a bar on 14th Street in Manhattan, and a talent night in the Catskills. She was doing so poorly, as a matter of fact, that her friends figured the fundraiser might be the only way the singer would come up with enough money for food and rent. Well, they didn't get enough money to buy many groceries or to pay the rent. By the end of the evening, they collected just $35. But fate had something better up her sleeve that evening. There was a gatecrasher at the party, an aspiring young agent who met the starving singer, liked her, and asked her to go out with him. 4 days later, he asked her to marry him, and she said yes, which was a very wise choice for Helen Reddy, because since then, husband and manager Jeff Wald has guided her career to superstardom. At number 19 this week, here's Helen Reddy and Somewhere in the Night.
Time, you found time enough.
Helen Reddy on American Top 40, who makes her home in Brentwood, California, at number 19 with Somewhere in the Night.
The hits from coast to coast.
This is Casey Kasem in Hollywood, and it's time now for the current hit by the superstar who was named Best Female Pop Vocalist by Billboard magazine 2 years in a row, but who says she probably wouldn't be singing at all today if not for a serious kidney disease that could have killed her. The lady, Helen Reddy. And when we spoke with her recently, she told us the dramatic story behind her singing career. She says her first love was dancing. And when she was 5 years old, her parents, who were part of a vaudeville troupe in Australia, taught Helen a couple of dance routines and took her on the road with them. Well, it was a dream come true for a little girl. And she continued dancing and performing with her folks all through her childhood, right into her teens. But when she was 12, she developed kidney problems that kept getting worse until she was 17. Finally, doctors were forced to remove one of her kidneys. Helen tells us that without the operation, the disease would have killed her. And the operation itself was so dangerous that she could have died during surgery. A grim situation for a young girl to face, but Helen came through the operation with flying colors. And after it was all over, she spent 2 months in the hospital and a full year at home recuperating. And the doctors made it very clear that her delicate physical condition made the strenuous movements of dancing strictly off limits. Helen Reddy tells us that giving up her dream of dancing was the biggest disappointment of her life. But she refused to let it defeat her, and she decided to concentrate instead on singing. Today, 17 years later, a lot of people are happy she did. In 1973, she was named Top Female Singles and Album Artist by Billboard magazine, and she repeated in 74 as Top Female Album Artist. This week, her latest hit single is at number 32. Here's Helen Reddy with I Can't Hear You No More.
Here you are again, telling me you're sorry, but
last week at 29, this week at 32. The fifth consecutive week on American Top 40 for Helen Reddy and I Can't Hear You No More.
Casey's Coast to Coast.